Today, I'm going to show you how to place anything in perfect perspective into a photo in Photoshop using one of my favorite filters, the Vanishing Point Filter. Hey there, and welcome to Phlearn. My name is Aaron Nace. You can find me on phlearn.com, where we make learning fun. Today's episode is super cool. Basically, anytime you want to do a mock-up or a photo composite where you want to place something, let's say on a wall, you have to calculate perspective. And doing that manually can be a little bit tough, but luckily there's a tool built into Photoshop that helps us do this automatically. So that's what we're gonna show you how to use in today's episode. We got a great tutorial for you. Let's jump into Photoshop. So here are the sample images for today. You can actually download these and follow along on phlearn.com. Just follow the link right down below. We're including the PSD as well. So let's go ahead and jump in. Our first image here, basically I wanna take this print that says, "You are our greatest adventure." Oh, how sweet. And first I just need to straighten this out a little bit. So let's grab our marquee tool. I'm just gonna make a little bit of a larger selection than I need and hit Control or Command J. And we're gonna put that basically on its own layer. And you're gonna see it has a little bit of a shadow with it already. Okay. Now, on its own layer, we're just gonna go ahead and move this into our new frame. So let's just click and drag, boom. And here it is in our new image. And you can see it's not in perspective, so it doesn't look real. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at some of the light in our background image because we need that to match. So the light direction in the background photo is coming from this way. And we can see that on this pot, for instance, like there's a highlight on this side and a shadow on this side. So that tells us the light's coming from that direction. Now, the light on this image is coming from this direction. You can see the highlight here on the picture frame and a little bit of a shadow right over here. So we need to flip this image. Only issue is the fact that the center of our photograph, we don't want to flip that, right? Because it's, the text would be backwards. If you hit Control or Command T, flip this horizontal, you know, that doesn't work. So what we're gonna do is separate this out, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead and make a marquee selection right here around this area, boom, and hit Control or Command J. That's gonna put this on a new layer. So we just have this, and then my background will hit Control or Command T and then right click and flip that horizontally. Boom, do you see that? So let's hit undo and then redo again. Okay, so we just flipped the frame and then of course this layer, you know, flipped the art as well, but we copied the art onto a new layer, so we should be good to go. Now I do want to straighten this out. I'm gonna hit Control or Command R, which brings up my rulers, and you can click and drag from the top down your rulers there, and this is gonna bring in guides. So let's just drag from the left to the right now. There we go, and you can see we have some guides because I want this to be, not slanted a little bit. So let's hit Control or Command T. So here are the guides basically telling us like this is, you know, now we have a goal, right? This is pretty, you know, accurate with this corner of the frame. Here you can see we're a little bit too low. And here we can see, let's go ahead and get one of these here as well. Boom. So you can see this is not perpendicular. So we just need to make it perpendicular. Now, it's actually really easy to do. Just hit Control or Command T for your transform. And then I can just hold Control and click on these little corners there. Boop. And we're just going to move this one up. Boop. And if you say boop, it works a lot better. There we go, boop, and hit enter. There we go. And now we can see the picture frame is a lot more squared in the actual photo. So it's just a super simple skew. Now I wanna do the same thing with this. There we are, just so everything is nice and square because we're gonna wind up cutting this frame out from the background. Okay, let's go ahead and zoom in there. And now we're gonna do the same thing with our print. So Control or Command T, there we are. I'm just gonna bring this in each one of these corners until it aligns perfectly with my little grid. Oh, I don't have a grid on the bottom here, so let's go ahead and make one. There we are. couldn't be easier. And hit enter when you're done. So there we go, everything is on a grid. Now I'm just gonna go to view, and then I'm gonna go down to clear guides, those blue guides, I don't need them anymore. So we're just gonna clear them out. Now, in this case, we could most definitely try to use some of the shadow from the picture frame, but what I would rather do is just generate our shadow with layer effects. So let's go ahead and take these two layers, and we're just gonna merge them back together again. So now the light is coming from the correct direction here. So let's hit Control or Command E to merge them together. And now we grab our marquee tool. There we go, go up to the top corner and down there. And we just wanna make sure we're in about the right location. It doesn't have to be perfect because we're just using a layer mask, but we want it to be pretty good. Okay, so now that we have that selection, let's just click on our layer mask. And I think this looks pretty, pretty good. So we are ready for our vanishing point filter. So this layer looks good, obviously just not in perspective. Now I'm gonna go ahead and apply this layer mask. Let's just right click and go to apply layer mask. Okay. Now this layer here, basically what I need to do is get the contents of this layer on my clipboard, okay? Like anytime you copy and paste, that's putting something on your clipboard. So super easy, just hold Control or Command and click on the layer itself. And that just turns the layer into a selection. So now you can see I've got a selection around my photo frame. And just go Control or Command C, so just copy. You can just go to Edit and down to Copy also. So that's on my clipboard now, and we can just make it invisible and deselect. What's the word? So it's in our clipboard, and that's all it needs for our vanishing point filter. Now what we're gonna do is create a new layer. This is important. You don't want to use your background layer. You want to do a new layer here. Okay, so we made a selection out of this layer, copied it, it's on our clipboard, and I made a new layer, and now it's time to paste it. But I'm not just gonna go paste it onto this new layer, which I could just hit Control or Command V and then pop, now it's on that layer. I don't wanna do that just yet because we're gonna do our vanishing point filter. So let's show you how to do it. It's actually super cool. I've used this for so many things, compositing, getting people in the right perspective, it's awesome. So we're gonna go to filter and we're gonna go to vanishing point. This is one of those ones that, like, I don't know, for the longest time I never even used in Photoshop, but it's really cool. So let's go ahead and click. Basically, we want to click on some visual cues here in our image, right? We want to create perspective. So this is just going to go straight up and down, pretty much. There we go. Come across there, and then come back down to there. Boom. And it's going to build you a perspective grid. And if it's not perfect, you can simply just click here and move this around. Let's just move this one around there. That looks pretty good. You would basically just want the sides to be straight up and down, and then this we're trying to follow, follow the actual line there. So we have our grid in there. How do we get the picture frame into this grid? Well, all you have to do is paste it in. Remember earlier we hit Control or Command C for copy. Now we just have to hit Control or Command V for paste. So here we go, Control or Command V, boom, paste. Now it just puts it up there, but if you click and drag it into this frame, look at that. If I put it out there, it's automatically now in perspective. So once it goes in this frame, it automatically goes into the right perspective. And you can still transform it. So if I hit Control or Command T, I can now transform it because it skewed perspective a little bit. Just if this isn't a perfect square here, it's going to skew your perspective. So you just need to stretch it back down a little bit. But check this out. Now, what? And can you see how it gets bigger? It's bigger over here and it gets smaller as we go down there. So anywhere I put this, it's basically gonna be perfectly aligned with the wall because it uses this vanishing point filter to get it there, which is so, so cool. All right, there we go. Let's just put it right about here, maybe make it a little bit smaller. You are our greatest adventure, I agree. That looks really cool. So the vanishing point filter, basically you just draw your perspective and then hit paste and it pops it in there automatically in the right perspective. It's so cool. So let's go ahead and hit okay. And then now this is just on this new layer and perfectly in perspective, but it doesn't look real just yet. And there are a couple of reasons why. One is that my light levels don't really make sense with the image. And two, we don't have a shadow. So let's take care of our light levels first. A great way to do this is I'm just gonna grab my adjustment layers and go to black and white. Boom. Okay. Now, when you make a black and white layer, this isn't going to be on here for permanent. It's just here so I can look at the relative light levels of my image. And right now, it might be obvious, but the white area of my photo frame is way too bright, right? It's like, ooh, that doesn't look right. So what we need to do is we need to make a levels or a curves adjustment layer, but we're gonna use levels. Okay, so levels. Now, here's the deal. If I adjust my levels right now, it's gonna do it on my whole image, okay? But if I clip this to the picture frame using this little clipping mask icon right there, or you can right click, where's my little right click at? There you are. Go to right click and go to create clipping mask. Same thing. So this little button here, you can see it pushes it over to the side and you get a little down arrow. That is the same thing as right clicking and go to create clipping mask. You can also hit Option Command G. Okay, always five ways to do things in Photoshop. So let's go ahead and reset this. Now, what we want to do is make the white area less bright. Okay, so I need to take my whites and make them darker. And that's just right here. That's this little slider right here. Boom, look at this. I just make my white area less bright. And then right about there, that looks way better. I'm gonna take my blacks and make them a little bit less black, less dark as well, okay? To match our image. So look at that. That's a pretty big change. Already it's like, oh, okay, we're kind of getting there. It still kind of looks two-dimensional, but it looks a heck of a lot better than it did. The next thing that I want to do just for like fun's sake, because it's gonna be fun, is I wanna try to create a little bit of perspective behind, I wanna create like the side of this picture frame. So here's how we're gonna do this. I'm gonna create a new layer under my picture frame. There we go. And we're just gonna basically make a selection out of our picture frame, okay? So the picture frame is selected. Again, just hold Control or Command, click on the picture frame, and then I'm gonna hit M for my marquee tool, okay? And we're just gonna go up like this, just a little bit, okay? Give it some thickness, and then I'm gonna hit B for my brush tool, and we're just gonna grab this color. There we go. And I'm gonna hit Control or Command H so I can see what I'm doing a little bit better. I did not mean to drag that out. There we go. And we're just gonna paint this in. It's gonna give us a little bit more thickness here. There we go, something like that. Now I know it's not perfect just now, so we need to zoom in here. There we go. And I'm gonna hit L for my lasso tool. I'm gonna hold down Alt or Option and then just connect these up. Boop, boop, boop. Look at that. We have thickness. Houston, we have thickness. That's not a thing. There we go. And connect this up down there. And I guess we need to add that to it too. All right, and then B for the brush tool. We'll just paint this in. This is looking awesome. I know that doesn't match right now, but we'll just lock the transparency of this. Oh, that's not working. Just make it into a selection and then paint it. All right, we need to do the same thing down there as well. And then this is, should be a little bit darker, right? So we're gonna hit Control or Command L for our levels, boom. And we'll just make this a little bit darker. So we're just putting our blacks up. Cool, so we have a little bit of thickness there. All right, maybe it should be a little bit thicker, but I think that looks pretty good. So now we're looking a lot more like, hey, that's in perspective, right? Fantastic. I think this should be a little bit more slanty. So I'm just gonna grab my lasso tool, boom, and do something like that, and then put that as a layer mask and then invert it. That's just gonna change that perspective a little bit. Cool, that looks better. So now what we need to do is, I need to add a shadow to this, right? Because it doesn't really look that good. I'm just gonna adjust my light levels too because it was a little bit too dark. There we go, that looks much more real. Look at that. Added thickness to a photo frame. Okay, so it doesn't look that real. Basically, it's because there's no shadow. So there's a lot of ways you can do this, but I'm just gonna group all these layers together, and then guess what? You can make FX, the color effects, like drop shadows and stuff. You can do that on a whole group. So that's what we're gonna do. So I'm gonna go in here and we're gonna just add a drop shadow. First thing we need to do is work on our angle. So the angle of the shadow, we want to be, you know, I'm gonna look at this clock for reference, okay? So angle, yeah, right about there, looks pretty good. Okay, now let's go ahead and add some distance to it. There we go. And we're going to add some size to it too. There we are. Now let's continue to add some more distance. There we go. Not that much. And we're going to want to just go a little bit less with the size because it's not that far off the wall, right? Like if you do this, it makes it look like it's further off the wall. Cool. Now, this doesn't look real just yet for a couple of reasons. One is anytime you do shadow work in Photoshop, you need more than one layer. It just never looks good with just one layer. Second reason is the color of the shadow doesn't match my image at all, right? So we need to click on our color here. We just go with our little eyedropper, okay? And I'm gonna choose the color, boom, right there, right? Maybe that color right there. Cool. So now we at least have the right color. Now, what we're gonna do is take down the opacity of this shadow here. There we go. And bring up the size just a little bit. Okay. And then that makes up our first shadow. So we need a second shadow in here, at least to give it a little bit of like local. Let's look at this shadow here. You see how there's a shadow right where the clock meets the wall that's like dark and relatively well-defined. And then you have this bigger one out here. You need at least a couple shadows, surprisingly, right? You think you could do it with one, but it never looks real. So we just click this little plus icon, boom. I'm gonna just change my distance and change my size. There we go. And we're gonna bring up our opacity a little bit. And now we have a shadow, okay? That's right next to our picture frame. So our first shadow, there we go, like the big one. And then we have the small one right next to it. So you can see, each one of these, if I just had that, not realistic, okay? If I just had that, not realistic. But once we add a couple of these, it's looking a lot more realistic, right? Let's go ahead and bring our size up a little bit more. We're gonna bring up our distance a little bit more, and then we're gonna bring our opacity down. Oh, look at that. So three shadows, right? Three drop shadows. It's not hard to do. You just click that little plus icon, but basically, you want one that's like right beside the picture frame or whatever you're trying to, if you want to composite a person on a floor, do this as well. So one right beside it, okay, that's like relatively thin, well-defined, and darker. Then you do a medium one, and then you do a bigger one, and it should get less visible and more spready. That's not a word. It should get more feathered out as it gets farther away. So each one of these shadows adds depth and realism to our image. Boom, check that out. And I did that to the entire group. So I can go in here and I can still change all the settings. This is completely non-destructive. I can turn any of these shadows off and on right here in this dialogue, and we are good to go. Not to mention, I can just move this around now, right? I mean, it looks pretty dang good. But I got one more step that I want to do. You see this dark shadow for the plant? I want to integrate that into this picture a little bit more. So what we're going to do is I'm going to create a new layer, hit B for the brush tool, and we're just going to sample this color. I'm going to paint over the picture frame just a little bit like that. Okay? Oh, such an artist. Now, I want this to only be visible where this picture frame is visible. So what I'm going to do is clip this shadow to the picture frame. Just right click and go to create a clipping mask. Now earlier we used a clipping mask here, I'll show you. Remember this clipping mask? It's a levels adjustment layer that we clipped to the photo frame, okay? Check this out, I'm clipping this layer, okay? Unclip, clip, you can see how it becomes only visible where the shadow is. I'm clipping this to an entire group. Who knew you can clip a layer to an entire group and you can apply layer effects on an entire group? Awesome. So now this is only visible where my picture frame is. Super cool. We just changed our layer blend mode from normal to multiply, which just makes it darker so it's not going to get any lighter. Okay. Then I added a little Gaussian blur because it doesn't look good at all. So Gaussian blur it up. There we go. Something right about there. And then I just lower the opacity of this a little bit until it, you know, it gets subtle. But now it looks like we have some interaction between the plant and that picture frame, and then boom, that's a realistic composite. I look at this picture and I don't think they added that, you know what I mean? And look at this, I can still move this around and that shadow stays in the same place because the shadow is on a new layer clip to it. So I can just move this around, put it where I want. You can see how the shadow comes in and out of that display. I can move this around, put it exactly where I want, and we are good to go. And again, I can turn off my layer effects at any time. Completely non-destructive workflow. Now, this layer here, we don't need it anymore. Delete it. And the black and white layer, we don't need that anymore either. So we've got a really, really great composite with a lot of help from our friend, the Vanishing Point Filter, as well as clipping masks and a levels adjustment layer. I'm gonna be including not only this image, but also this PSD available for free download on Phlearn.com. So if you wanna tear this apart and see how it was done and recreate it, you know, or do your own type of compositing, this should help you out. So just follow the link right down below and you can get access to that. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you guys are just getting started and wanna learn a lot more Photoshop, things like compositing, retouching, special effects, Lightroom photography, I mean, just a crazy amount of stuff. Check out Phlearn Pro. We have an entire catalog with thousands of hours of wonderful tutorials that are gonna help you out. And it's a subscription, so you just basically hit subscribe and you get access to everything we've ever done. It's totally awesome. Thank you so much for watching. I'll Phlearn you later. Bye, everyone.